So today, the best thing that I can do is not only to pray for you, but also to give you a word of hope, to give you a word of peace, a word of encouragement. All of us are facing discouragement. All of us are facing all kinds of adversities. All of us are facing, you know, series na parang sinasabi natin, come on, sunod-sunod na pagsubok, sunod-sunod na mga hamon ng buhay. Pero ngayon, I want to declare to you na kung may sunod-sunod na pagsubok, the more tayo meron dapat sunod-sunod na pagsamba sa Diyos. Sunod-sunod na pagsunod sa Diyos. Yung pagsunod na hindi napuputol ng kahit anong bagyo, ay hindi pwedeng putulin ang pagpupuri natin sa Diyos. Na hindi, that the storm can never stop our praises to Him. That we're gonna continue on, we're gonna praise Him. And so that today, I want to read God's Word to you, to comfort you and to strengthen you. And the Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 12, starting on verse 7, and I pray that this will be a big comfort and a strength to you in the name of Jesus. Here's the Word. And the one who's written this Word is Paul. And Paul has testified about how the Lord is providing strength in the lowest low of his life. And I want you today that you're going to discover today that even in your lowest low, God can provide a strength for you. That even in your discouraging moments, God will always be there for you. And I want to encourage you through the Word. So I'm going to read this for you. Are you ready? Here's the Word. The Word of God says in 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 7, it says, because of the extravagance of those revelations, and so I wouldn't get a big head, I was given the gift of a handicap to keep me in a constant touch with my limitations. Satan's angel did his best to get me down. What he in fact did was push me to my knees. Oh, amen. Can somebody say amen with that verse? No danger then of walking around high and mighty. At first I didn't think of it as a gift and begged God to remove it. Three times I did that, and then he told me, my grace is enough, or my grace is sufficient for you. My grace is enough. It's all you need. My strength comes into its own in your weakness. Once I heard that, I was glad to let it happen. And I quit focusing on the handicap and began appreciating the gift. It was a case of Christ's strength moving in on my weakness. Now I take limitations in stride and with good cheer. These limitations that cut me down to size, abuse, accidents, oppositions, bad breaks, I just let Christ take over. And so the weaker I get, the stronger I become. The weaker I get, the stronger I become. I want to declare to you, and let us declare together, that no matter what we are facing, all kinds of adversities, or any kind of storm, any kind of trials, I want to tell you that you have a choice to make. That you have a choice, that you cannot let the storm stop you. That you cannot let anything stop you. That what intends to make you weak can actually make you stronger. And you can declare with me today that you're going to declare to me and you're going to declare to the world and to yourself that I may pass through all of these adversities, that I may face all kinds of challenges, but you can declare with me that I'm going to come out of this stronger. I want to declare it to you, and that's my message for you today, that you may pass through all kinds of challenges, you may pass through all kinds of trials, but I want to declare to you that you're going to pass all those things stronger, that you're going to come out of it stronger. Oh, come on, can you declare with me that I may be facing all these kinds of storms, I may be facing all series, parang walang katapusan na pagsubok, but I want to declare today that I'm going to come out of this stronger. I will not come out of this weaker. I will not come out of this as a loser. I'm going to come out of this as a winner. I'm going to come out of this stronger. Why? Because I will not waste my crisis. I will not waste. This crisis is already happening. I want to take advantage of it in a way that it will make me stronger. My job for me today is to tell you and to encourage you how God can use all these things to make you stronger. You know, the goal of the enemy is to make you weaker, to make us feeling loser, to make us feel we are insignificant, to make us feel that we are so discouraged. But can I tell you that the power of the Lord is beyond feelings. Kaya ni Lord na pagtagumpayan mo ang buhay kahit ano pa ang pinagdadaanan mo sa ngayon. And I want you to declare with me, malalampasan mo ito. At ikaw, hindi mo lang basta malalampasan, kundi ito ay mapagtatagumpayan mo. Naaalis ka, malalampasan mo to, na ikaw ay mas lalo pang malakas kaysa sa dati. Hindi ka manghihina, bagkos ang bagay na dapat manghina para sa iyo, ayun ay magpapalakas sa iyo. So I want to declare to you that you're gonna come out of this stronger. Come on, declare with me, I'm gonna come out of this stronger. I'm gonna come out of this as a winner. I will not be a loser. I will not waste my crisis. I will not waste all the pain. Nasaktan na tayo, na-discouraged na tayo, umiyak na tayo, nalungkot na tayo. Huwag natin sayangin yung pain na napagdaanan natin because we believe that in the name of Jesus, may darating na mas magandang umaga, may darating na mas magandang pagpapala, may darating na bagong kinabukasan. And I want to tell you, I don't want to miss what's behind all these trials. I want to face it in the name of Jesus stronger. And I want to declare to you in the name of Jesus, even though you are crying, even though you're feeling so alone, even though you are feeling so destitute, even though you are feeling so lost, I want to tell you that the power of the Lord is upon you, because the power of God is not an emotion. The power of the Lord is a position who you have in Jesus' name. And that is why I want to declare to you, lahat na napagdadaanan mo sa ngayon, I want to tell you na hindi ka kailanman lubusang lulugmok sa ganyang sitwasyon. Makakabangon ka, malalampasan mo at napagtatagumpayan mo. I don't want to come out of this as a loser. I'm gonna come out of this as a winner. I'm gonna come out of this stronger. The first thing that you have to learn is this. We become stronger through hardships. The Word of God says, He said, because of the extravagance of this revelation, I was given the gift of a handicap. Those are hardships, limitations. You know, the Word of God says that this, He's been taking about the limitations, about the handicap, the bad breaks, the abuse, the accidents, the opposition. All of those are hardships. But I want to tell you and want to declare to you that the hardships that are meant to weaken you is actually strengthening you. So you become stronger through hardships. Hindi ang hardship, ito ang crazy. Itapon ang hardship sa hindi Kristiyano, sa hindi anak ng Diyos. Talagang panghinaan siya ng loob. Pero sa isang anak ng Diyos, baliktad ang nangyayari. The more hardship ang itapon mo sa Kanya, you will find out that the more hardships, the more strength that He is piling up in Himself. You know why? Because hardships will never break a child of God who is fully trusting the Lord. I want to declare to you that you may have plenty of hardships, but I want to tell you, all hardships can be converted into strength. So the more hardships that we have, God is converting it into a strength. For what? For your purpose, for your family. Na magugulat ka na lang, ang iba pinanghinaan na ng loob, pero ikaw ay nakakapit pa rin dahil alam mo sa likod ng pangapagsubok na to ay isang matinding pagpapala. Gusto kong linawin po sa inyo na kung may sunod-sunod na pagsubok, huwag kayo mag-alala, may darating din na sunod-sunod na pagpapala. Come on, can everybody clap your hands for God? And I want to tell you, you become stronger through hardships. But not only that, Paul said, I was given the gift of a handicap. Take note of this. To keep me in constant touch with my limitations. The second thing that makes you stronger is this. Not only that you become stronger through hardships, but you become stronger through humility. Paul said here that because of this handicap, it enabled me to keep me in constant touch with my limitations. O diba sa panahon na tayo hirap na hirap, sa panahon na tayo ay natatakot, doon natin naunawaan kung gaano tayo kahina. Naunawaan natin na kaya pala natin umiyak. At sa panahon ng kababaan, doon natin nasusukat na hindi natin kaya, na wala ang Diyos. Doon tayo natututo na tumawag. Doon tayo natututo na magtiwala sa Diyos. Ano ang point? Tayo ay nagiging mapagkumbaba. And can I tell you, sa panahon ng pagpapakumbaba na tumatawag tayo sa Diyos, humihingi tayo ng tulong sa Diyos, tayo ay nagpapakumbaba na inaamin natin na hindi natin kaya. But today I want to declare to you that there is strength in humility. Pero sa panahon ng iyong kababaan, sa panahon na ikaw umamin na hindi mo kaya, oh, I want to tell you, baliktad kung kailan mo sinasabi na hindi mo kaya, ang totoo, the more mo kaya. Bakit? Kasi nakadepende ka sa kakayanan ng Diyos at hindi sa kakayanan mo. Humility. You become stronger through humility. Hindi lang humility sa Diyos. O diba sa kababaan ng buhay, kahirapan, sa pagsubok, natututo tayo magpakumbaba. Natututo tayo na huwag magyabang, na huwag natin tratuhin ang ibang tao na mas lesser sila sa atin. Natututo tayo na tratuhin natin ang ibang tao with honor, with paggalang, with respeto. And I want to declare to you, yan ang purpose ng hardships, yan ang purpose ng adversity, to make us humble. And this is what I realize, karamihan ng kilala kong tao mapagkumbaba, subok ko na ang dami nilang pinagdaanan sa buhay. Pero dahil sa pinagdaanan nila sa buhay, natuto silang magtiwala sa Diyos. And they are declaring that all this hardship that I'm passing through, I'm gonna come out of this stronger, not weaker, but stronger. So stronger through hardships, stronger through humility. But not only that, I want this to be read to you. He said, Satan's angel did his best to get me down. Oh, this is so good. He said, Satan's angel did his best to get me down. What he in fact did was to push me to my knees. Oh, are you getting that? What Paul was saying, that the enemy is trying to knock me out, but I was never knocked out. I may be knocked down, but the purpose of me being knocked down is for me to be on my knees so that I can pray and I can call upon the Lord. Or can I tell you that you become stronger through honest prayer? You can never be stronger in life if you don't pray. Let me tell you, there are many times na ikaw ay papabagsakin, tutumba ka, pero ang posture mo na pagkatumba ay hindi simbolo ng pagkatalo. Yan ay simbolo ng panalo. Kasi ang simbolo ng panalo ay ang taong nakaluhod sa harapan ng Diyos. Ang taong nakaluhod sa harapan ng Diyos ay palaging panalo. Oh, can I tell you that? That a person who is kneeling before God is never a loser. A person who is kneeling before God is always a winner. That is why I want to tell you, if you are praying before the storm, if you are praying during the storm, if you are praying after the storm, I want to tell you that you are the person I'm talking to. You're gonna come out of your trial stronger. You're gonna come out of any crisis stronger because you become stronger through hardship. You become stronger through humility, and you become stronger through honest prayer. And not only that, I want to read this word. No danger then of walking around high and mighty. At first, I didn't think of it as a gift and begged God to remove it. So may pinagdadaanan si Paul na katulad natin. Sino rito nakaka-relate kay Paul na katulad niya, nagpipray tayo kay Lord, na Lord, pwede po ba alisin niyo na po ito? Lord, sana matapos na to. Lord, sana pakialis na po. Sana itong problema, itong hinaharap po ito ay matapos na. How many of you can relate with Paul with that kind of prayer? Sabi ni Paul, I pray to the Lord 3 times too that He will remove it. But here's the response of the Lord. Pakinggan niyo pong mabuti because this may be the answer of your questions na matagal mo nang tinatanong sa Diyos. Bakit may pinagpipray ka na hanggang ngayon hindi pa rin sinasagot ng Diyos. O may pinagpipray ka na maalis o magtapos pero hindi pa rin natatapos. Ito ang sagot ni Lord. Sabi ni Paul, 3 times I did that and then he told me, my grace is sufficient for you. My grace is enough. It's all you need. What a word. My grace is enough. My grace is sufficient for you. What God is telling you is this. We equate the grace of the Lord depending on the blessing. At doon tayo nagkakamali na porque walang blessing, walang grace si God. Hindi tayo natin naunuan na yung grace matagal nang binigay ni Lord. Actually, nasa iyo na. Oh, I pray that this will be a comfort to you. The grace of the Lord is already in your life. Will be given to you. It's already been given to you. It's already in you. And God is saying, it is sufficient for you. Kaya mo. Kaya mo. Walang pagsubok na harapin ka na hindi mo kaya. Kaya hinayaan ng Diyos yan na ipaabot sa iyo dahil alam ni God, His grace in you is sufficient. Kaya mo because that's what you need. That is why I want to encourage you, you become stronger when you have a proper perspective in life. Sa una, hindi naunawaan ni Paul ang purpose ng isang challenge para sa kanya. But after encountering the grace of the Lord, naunawaan niya, nagkaroon siya ng tamang pananaw. I want to tell you guys is that you become stronger through higher perspective. Higher perspective is that meron kang pag-unawa na naunawaan mo ngayon ang kalooban ng Diyos para sa iyo. Na may mga bagay na kung minsan iniiyak mo sa Panginoon. May mga pagkakataon na hindi mo maunawaan. But can I tell you, the moment you've changed your focus into the Lord, babaguhin ni Lord ang pananaw mo sa buhay. And I want to tell you in the name of Jesus, when you have a higher perspective, that's the time that you're gonna have the strength that is coming from the Lord. And that is why He said, my grace is enough, it's all you need, my strength comes into its own in your weakness. And He said this word, once I heard that, I was glad to let it happen. Take note of these words. I quit focusing on the handicap and began appreciating the gift. What a decision to make in life. He said, I quit. Saan siya nag-quit? I quit focusing on the things that doesn't work right. I quit focusing on all the bad things that are happening in my life. I quit focusing on the bad breaks. I quit focusing on all the heartaches. And I want to tell you that he said, I quit focusing on the handicap and began appreciating the gift. I want to tell you that you become stronger not only through hardship, you become stronger not only through humility, not only you become stronger through honest prayer, not only you become stronger through higher perspective, but you become stronger through honor. When you honor the Lord in spite of what's happening to you, you become stronger in life. And how do you become stronger through honor? Here's the secret. He said, I quit focusing on the things that doesn't work out right, and I start focusing on the gift. Honor is this. Thanksgiving. How many of us, pagkatapos ng bagyo, lahat tayo nagpasalamat? Lord, salamat na sumikat ulit ang araw. Lord, salamat na kami ay naligtas. Salamat, Lord, na kami ay nakalampas. Lahat tayo ay bukang bibig natin, lahat tayo nagpapasalamat. Anong tawag doon? Honor. And I want to tell you, sa isang taong mapagpasalamat, palaging may tagumpay na meron para sa kanya. Ang tao mapagpasalamat, palaging may strength na papasok sa buhay mo na di mo maintindihan saan ang galing, pero manggagaling yon pag natuto tayo magpasalamat. Ikaw, nung pagkatapos ng bagyo, anong mga bagay ang pinasalamatan mo? Kasi pag tinignan natin yung mga bagay na nawala, tayo talaga ay manghihina. Pero pag tinignan natin yung mga bagay na binigay ng Diyos, tayo ay magkakaroon ng lakas. I want to tell you this, that in the name of Jesus, you become stronger when you honor the Lord. You honor the Lord with the things that God has given you. You honor the Lord no matter what kind of situation. through the storm, we praise the Lord. We honor Him. That is why I want to thank God right now for you, for choosing today to honor Him on Sunday, to praise Him with all your might in spite of what happened this week. And that is why I want to tell you, you're going to face this trial and you're going to say, no, I'm going to come out of this stronger. The more my praise will be stronger, the more my worship will be stronger. You're going to say, I'm going to come out of this not limping, not as a loser, not as a whiner. I'm going to come out of this as a winner. I'm going to come out of this a stronger Christian, stronger in my praise. But also I want to emphasize you something here. About the gift. It's one thing to receive a gift, but it's a higher level to give a gift. That is why I want to emphasize also these things. If you want to become stronger even in the time of trials, here's the thing. Are you ready? Here's the thing. You become stronger when you help others. What I'm saying is that it's one thing to receive a gift, but it's a powerful thing if you are the one giving the gift. It's one thing to be helped, but it's a greater thing if you can help others. That is why I want to tell you, amazing yung mga tao na kahit sila man ay nagdaan din ng bagyo, pero iniisip pa rin nila paano makatulong. I want to tell you that you become stronger when you help others. You become weaker when you just live for yourself. The reason why you are feeling so weak is all you think about is yourself. The way out of that, the way to become stronger, is to stop thinking all about yourself and start to think about others. Here's the secret. Those people who always find a way to help others, those are the strongest people. You know why? Because I know them. That even though they have a heartache too, even though they have discouragement too, even though they have pains, even though they have challenges too, and yet they still choose to help others. And in helping others, they almost forgot that they have challenges too. Oh, I want to honor those people. I just remember, I'm just thinking, all of the rescuers, all of those frontliners who are risking their lives just to save people during the storm. Hindi ko sabihin na wala silang pagsubok, hindi ko sabihin na wala silang pinagdadaanan, but amazing na kaya nila kalimutan yung kanilang pinagdadaanan, makatulong lang sa iba. At yun ang sign ng isang stronger person. I want to encourage you, if you want to become stronger in these times, this is the time for you to help others. Stronger through helping others. So what an amazing revelation for God today, that even though there's hardships, there's challenges, you become stronger through hardships. You become stronger through humility. You become stronger through honest prayer. You become stronger through higher perspective. You become stronger through honor. And you become stronger through helping others. But to sum it all up, the only way for you to become stronger is only through Jesus. So the last one I want to tell you is you become stronger through Him. Only Him. And His name is Jesus. I want to tell you, we cannot become stronger by ourselves. We can never be stronger just by ourselves. We can never be stronger with our own abilities and our strength and our own ideas. The only way to become stronger in life is Jesus. Let me explain. The verse said, it was a case of Christ's strength moving in on my weakness. Now I take limitations in stride and with good cheer. These limitations that cut me down to size, abuse, accidents, opposition, bad breaks, take note of the word. I just let Christ take over. And so the weaker I get, the stronger I become. Isn't that ironic that even hardships, limitations, bad breaks, and failures and hard times, God can use it not to make you weaker, but to make you stronger. How? Only Jesus can do that. And that's the reason why yan ang kaibahan na may Kristo sa buhay. Hindi mo sinusolo ang problema mo dahil alam mo na may kasama ka na kailanman di ka bibitawan, di ka pababayaan. And I want to encourage you that you can only become stronger through Him, through Jesus. And Paul said, I let Christ take over. And so the weaker I get, the stronger I become. These hardships will not make me weaker. These hardships will make me stronger. I'm gonna come out of this stronger. That's a declaration that you can declare today, that no matter what the enemy is trying to put you down, you're gonna come out of this stronger. No matter what adversity is throwing at you, you're gonna come out of this stronger. No matter what the pain is so painful to you, you're gonna come out of this stronger. You will become better with this. You will become stronger than this. You will become a winner in Jesus' name. Why? Because you are not alone. Jesus, the one who can make you a winner, is with you. So come on, why not declare today that even all these things that are happening in your life, you can tell to the world and you can tell to yourself, I gotta come out of this stronger in the name of Jesus. Sasabihin mo sa Panginoon, sa lahat, sa sarili mo, na hindi ito ang ikakatumba ko, ito ang ikakabangon. Hindi rito nagtatapos ang kwento ng buhay ko. Dito pa lang ako magsisimula. Hindi rito magkakaroon ng dilim ang buhay ko. Dito magkakaroon ng liwanag. Hindi ako mawawala ng pag-asa. Ako ay babangon. At the more ako ay lalakas.
Sa'yo, O Panginoon.
I want to tell you dahil sa mensaheng ito, naunawaan mo na hindi ka pala nag-iisa, na kaya mo dahil may Kristo ka sa buhay mo. Pero higit pa dyan, hindi lang sa pag-solve ng problema ang pakay ng Diyos para sa'yo. Hindi lang para makat-ahon ka sa lahat ng pagsubok. Higit pa dyan, ang nais ng Diyos ay magkaroon ka ng katiyakan ng langit. Magkaroon ka ng kapatawaran. Magkaroon ka ng kasiguruhan na sa pamamagitan ni Jesus Christ, pwede ka magkaroon ng katiyakan ng kaligtasan. Kasi ito yung kalakasan ng tunay na Kristiyano. Na alam niya kahit anong bagyo, kahit anong mangyari sa buhay, alam naman nila na sa langit ang pupuntahan nila. Yan ang reason kung bakit stronger ang Kristiyano kahit anong mangyari. And I want to share this to you. I want this to impart it to you. Na pwede mong matanggap itong kasiguruhan na to na yes, pwede mong matiyak ang langit, pwede mong magkaroon ng kaligtasan, pwede mong matanggap ang pag-asa ng buhay, pwede mong matanggap ang kaligtasan na to. Paano? Kapag tinanggap mo ang may-ari ng lahat ng ito, wala nang iba kundi si Jesus Christ. Jesus is the only answer. So I want to encourage you, kung pinapakinggan mo to, hindi nagkataon na nadidinig mo to. God is speaking to your heart. At itong mga nangyari sa buhay mo, ito ay hinayaan lang ni Lord so that dumating ka sa pagkakataong ito na ikaw ay magpakumbaba at tanggapin mo siya bilang tagapagligtas. I want to offer this salvation to you which is free. He can save you. He wants to save you. He loves you. He has big plans for you. So if you want to open your heart at gusto mo finally tanggapin mo si Jesus Christ, sasabihin mo na, Lord, kung anong plano mo sa buhay ko, gawin mo po. And this is the day that I want to lead you to prayer. Here is the prayer and I want to lead you in prayer. Sumunod po kayo sa panalangin na to. Panginoong Diyos, salamat po sa pag-ibig nyo na kailanman hindi nagbabago. Sa araw na to, tinatanggap ko na ako'y makasalanan at kailangan ko kayo. Nais ko pong maligtas, nais ko pong mapatawad sa aking mga kasalanan. At salamat Panginoon na namatay ka sa krus para bayaran ang aking lahat ng aking pagkakamali. At sa araw na to, binubuksan ko ang aking puso at tinatanggap kita bilang aking tagapagligtas. Salamat Panginoon sa kaligtasan na ito. Sa pangalan ni Jesus. Amen. I also want to pray this prayer in English so that anyone who is can understand Tagalog, they can still say this prayer with me. Here's a prayer of accepting Jesus. Lord Jesus, I accept you in my heart. I admit that I'm a sinner. I need your help. I need your salvation. I need your life. And today, Lord, I humble myself and I open my heart and I accept you as my personal Savior. Today is the start of a new life. Today is the start of a new strength that is coming from you. Thank you, Jesus, for the life that you've given me. And starting today, no matter what I'm facing, I am confident that with you I'm a winner. And in every struggle, every trial, I have the confidence to say that I'm gonna come out of this stronger. In the name of Jesus, amen.